Okay, let's carry on or do some proper problems. I have a thin film with a refractive index of 133 in air. My incident light is at that wavelength, almost perpendicular, and what I want to see on this side is bright light. So what does that tell me? If I want to see this, it means that N2 minus N1, if that equals M, it's going to be M if I see bright light. If I see black light, it's going to be M plus a half. Okay, but they say bright light, so we're just talking M. And then M equals from 0 to 1 to 2. So if you use this N2 N1 method, you start at M equals 0. When you use many of the method that many of the textbooks do, you've got to start at 1 because it's a different concept in understanding what they're trying to explain. Certainly with this, M starts at 0. M starts at 0. But just think about it. Just think about it. If I go from low to high, from 1 to 1.3, that means this reflected ray immediately is going to add a half a wavelength of phase. So that's already plus a half from that one. It goes straight through, refracted, there's no change. It comes back, but it goes from high to low. From high to low here, so there's certainly nothing changes as far as that's concerned. There's refraction on this side, so nothing happens there either. Nothing happens there either. So the only addition, if you see this as zero, there's a added half a wavelength in phase there, and it just depends how many wavelengths you can fit into twice this distance, how many wavelengths phase are going to be added to this one. So here we already have plus a half. Remember, if this was a half, I'm fitting in a half, another half, so I'm fitting in one extra wavelength. So it's going to be that phase plus one extra wavelength of phase. This was plus a half. The difference between those two is half. I'm going to get total destruction. If I make this a quarter, we already talked about that. So I can only fit in a quarter, and another quarter, I can only fit in another half a wavelength. So from there to there, I've added half a wavelength. From there to there, due to the reflection, I'm going from low to high refractive index, I've added a half a wavelength. So half and half, those two are in phase. So the question for the thinnest film I can use under these circumstances to give me total constructive interference there, it must be a quarter of the wavelength inside of there. So I don't even have to do any of this. Just through understanding the process of what wavelength fits in there, this concept, it's so easy to do. All I need to do is remember, I'm not talking about the wavelength there, I'm talking about the wavelength in there. And remember, the wavelength N equals wavelength in air on a vacuum divided by N. So all we're talking about here, I need a quarter of this. I need one quarter of lambda divided by N2. That's all I need. I didn't even have to write that in the equation. But let's do that equation. Let's see, we'll get exactly there. My N2, remember N, I have to say A because I have to differentiate different ones of them, okay? So N2 is going to be, what is my L? Well, L is twice this Y. It's going to be twice this Y divided by lambda inside of this, which is just, we've just seen, is lambda times that N. I'm just bringing the N because I'm dividing by lambda over N. I bring N into the numerator. So I'm going to have N2 minus N1. So I have 2Y N over lambda minus, what is this N1? What must this N1 be for this to work out? I want, it's going from lower to higher, so it's going from lower to higher. So on this side, I have 1 minus a half. Minus half. This N1 is a half. Because in that nothing distance, as it just reflects, there's no distance there, but I'm adding, as if by magic, a half a wavelength. So a half of wavelength fits into this spot. It's not really that spot, as I say, it's just as if by magic. It's not really magic, there's an explanation for that. But I add another half a wavelength. So that's minus a half, which is there. And that is going to equal 0 for my thinnest one. So that is going to equal 0 for my thinnest one. So 2y n over lambda equals a half. And what does y equal? Y is going to equal lambda goes to the top, not y. Oh, it's a problem for me. Lambda goes on top, and I have 2 times 2 is 4, 10, and that n is n2 because I'm talking about n2. Look at that, a quarter of lambda over n2, a quarter of lambda over n2. So you can do it the long way, figuring out equations, or you just understand what's happening. So simple, and you'll get to the same answer. Now, another problem. As is typical for physics textbook problems, they're going to give you exactly the same problem, they're just going to leave out some other variable now, whereas they give you the variable that you had to calculate before. So just seeing the exact same problem, so nothing has changed in your conceptual understanding of what is going on. It's only the unknown variable that has changed. Just look at the wording of the problem. Physics is word problems, nothing other than that. So, we are told we have a soap bubble, air, soap bubble, air. So the soap bubble is our thin film, and it has a refractive index of 1.33, making air above and below 1, so I'm going from lower to higher to lower. Okay? I do not know what the monochromatic light is that is shining in perpendicular to that film. What I am told though is, I make certain observations and I see at a film width of 245 nanometers, it is indeed the second thickest film that gives me total destructive interference from the side of the incident light. So those words contain so much information, so much of these blank spaces. Okay, so we don't know what the wavelength is in air. We know these refractive indexes. What is m? What is m there, that integer m? Well, they told me it's the second thickest. And m is always 0, 1, 2. So the second thickest one is going to be an m equals 1. That's going to be an m equals 1. Y is 245. What is N1? They told you what N1 was. They said, I have total destructive interference. Okay, that's not why you know what N1 is. We are going from a lower to a higher. We're going from a lower to a higher. I was running ahead of myself. We're running from a lower to a higher refractive index material. So what is N1 going to be? This first reflected array, it is going to add another half, it adds another half a wavelength in that unit length. So N1 is going to be a half. They also tell you, and this is what I was referring to, what N2 minus N1 is. They tell you, they want total destructive interference on that side. So what do you want? You want at least a half a wavelength. You want a half a wavelength. Difference on this side, but do you want half a wavelength difference? Is that half correct? It is indeed not correct, because we want the second thickest. So what we're talking about here is n plus a half. Let me put it that way. That makes it a lot easier to understand. I want destructive interference there. So N2 minus N1 is going to be N plus a half. N plus a half. If they said I want to see bright monochromatic light, the bright band, that means just M. And what is M? They told you what M is. M is 1 because they told you the second thickest that section can be. The second thickest that it is gave me total destruction. So this is going to equal 1 plus a half. That's 3/2. So that is the best way, you know, that is the best way to see this. Now, what is N? We know N equals L divided by lambda. So N2 is going to be L. What is L? Well, that's the total distance the wave travels. So it travels y and another y. So that's going to be 2y divided by lambda. Now, this is lambda inside, and we know that lambda inside equals lambda divided by n. So I can't express this over lambda subscript n because I don't know what that is, but I do know n and I do know lambda. So again, I'm going to write this as lambda, n over lambda. Okay, so N2 minus N1, it's got to equal 3 over 2, and that equals 2 y n over lambda minus a half, minus a half. If I take this half over to the other side, I have 3 over 2 plus 1 over 2, that's 4 over 2, that's 2. The 2's will cancel out, so I'm left with 1 equals y n over lambda, and getting lambda on its own, lambda equals y times n, problem solved. That gives you lambda directly in air, which is what we wanted. So the most important thing about this is to know what the m value is. M is the integer, and it starts at 0 for the thinnest, 1 second thinnest, 3 third thinnest, okay? And I'm going to write m plus a half because I want destructive interference. If I just wrote m, that means I wanted constructive interference. And if I wanted the thinnest one, if I didn't know what this wire was, which is exactly what the previous problem was, I'm just going to write a 0 there.